we're moving along to another time. So we released the second album, and then which had amazing songs, and it had Rough Day, which I think everyone can relate to.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Right now, I'm sure.
Yeah. real rough. Oh my gosh. Yes, you're right, actually. Yeah. Jeez, I'm going to put that on after this.
Yeah, so Over It, which features a cameo from Prinny Stevens. It's pretty.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
And then, so we
put
the second album, which was also amazing. And then we.
Yeah.
And then you reemerged with what I think, I don't know if this is true, you can confirm or deny this rumor, but the Young Divas. So the first lineup was
yes,
Kate and Emily. Is it true that when This Time I Know It's For Real came out, it was only meant to be a one-off single? I'm going crazy just to let you know. You'd be amazed how much I love you so.
It wasn't even supposed to be it wasn't really even a single, right? Like, so we basically got asked to record that to promote on radio a song so that we could promote the tour that we were going on, right? So they had like the idea was four solo acts coming together on tour, you know, and that was like our kind of promo song. It was a promo song, you know, that they were going to release it out there to the radio stations. And somehow it just took off on the on radio, and you know, it was pretty much at number one for I'm not sure how long. And we got a phone call from our the record label saying, and management saying, you guys need to get into the we have to actually make a video for this song. And the next week we were in the studio, and I think it took us a week and a bit to record the whole album.
Wow.
Yeah, because they were just like, let's get this going, like you know, there's a market for it, people are wanting this, let's do it. And it actually worked out, because then, you know, we went on tour, but we also had released that album and performed some of the songs from that album, you know, so it kind of gave us more repertoire to perform.
Yes, absolutely.
The different states that we went to. So it was great. Like, it just kind of, again, things just kind of worked out. And, you know, we were all really young at that time, and I guess a bit naive, you know, and we were all like, okay, let's do it. And just, went for it. And it was fun. It was great. I love those girls. You know, and everyone had a, like, each of us had different strengths, and when we came together, it was such a great, I thought it was a great kind of, it's just a great mix of voices and personalities.
Absolutely. And then when Ricky left to do what she had to do, Jess entered. That was the first time post Idol that people got to rediscover Jess before she's gone on to what she's
doing. That's right.
And I think.
Yes. Turn me loose. I gotta do it. Yes.
Like, what I wanted to ask about that was Jess was considerably a lot younger to the rest of you girls.
Yes. Jess was such a, like, a breath of fresh air to the group. Mm-hmm. You know, she was young, she was vibrant, she was exciting. Yes.
Did you girls feel it was more of a sisterhood and mentoring Jess into, mentoring her into what she was going to become? Or, like,
I think the three of us, like myself, Emily and Kate, we really did try and keep her safe and mentor her.
Yes.
You know, we really looked after her because, she was like 17 or 18.
Yeah.
17, maybe. We did have that sense of like big sister kind of thing. And we always call it, like, even now we call it little sissy, you know, when we chat to her. Yeah. There was definitely that. And she was so just the innocence is beautiful, you know, and she still is now. But like at that time, she had just she came second on Idol.
Yeah.
And I think they were trying to figure out what to do with her at that time. You know, they were trying to figure out, okay, how do we go about this? Do we, you know, release something on our own or do we do a solo thing with her or do we put her in this group? Mm. And so, we were so excited to have her. And, you know, she brought something totally different into the mix of things. You know, it was great. It was exciting. It was new. She's always going to be that little sister, you know, that we always kind of try and keep safe.
Yeah, she's like I think it's really interesting to see what opportunities can arise if you allow them, and I think that's a great place. And I think it's really nice to hear that you were like sisters to her, and not just her. I think it comes across like as it someone that listened to the Young Divas, but also someone that watched from afar that it was a real sister.
Yeah. So we all really always had that whole, you know, she's our little sister, we're going to take care of her and let's try, you know, just guide her, you know, and not even guide, but just be there for her and support her.
Yes.
In what she's about to kind of do in her career.
When you look at someone like Jess now,
or
even Emily or Kate or any of Ricky Lee, any of them, people that you've worked
with.
And even your own journey, do you look back to being on Idol as that was the door that has opened the floodgates to all these opportunities, or do you actually think it's your own individual personalities and your own life stories that have got you that far?
I think it's both. You know, I think before Idol, especially for me, I was always in search of something like this. I've always wanted this, you know, since I was 16, 15, you know, ever since I was a kid, I wanted to become a singer. I remember I used to tell my mom all the time, I want to become a singer, I want to do that, you know, whenever I'd see like Whitney on
yes.
Remember Video Hits and Rage and all that type of stuff, at the time I'd always be like, Mom, I want to do that one day, you know. So I always had that passion for it. I had like the drive that I had back then is very different from what it is now. I really do need to get back to that, you know, that, you know, when you're first, it's almost like when you're first kind of dating someone, just everything that you just want to make, you want to take every opportunity, you want to make that person feel great, all of those things. I had that drive for my career.
Absolutely.
You know, the same thing. And so then when Idol came along, that was just another kind of stepping stone for me. You know, I looked at it like, okay, this is another stepping stone. I'll keep moving forward and see where this kind of door, like, leads to.
Yes.
And then, you know, when Young Divas happened, none of us ever dreamt that it would be that, it would be so successful.
Yeah.
You know, it was, like I said before, it was all just a promo kind of song that we wanted to release out there to promote the tour. And that, you know, that was amazing. I feel like we all ended up where we needed to be. You know, I'm a very big believer in that. I think if you keep working hard, you keep taking the steps that you need to take, you'll end up where you want to get to. But it's you have to remember that the journey is not always going to be smooth sailing. Absolutely. You know, you're going to come against a lot of people who don't believe in you, a lot of opportunities that don't happen. A lot of people will promise you things that won't cut, you know, that they won't come through on. And that's okay, because that's all part of the journey. That's what makes you stronger.
Yeah.
That's what builds your character, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think like, there's so many things that we've touched on, a lot of stuff so far. Touched on from school and Idol and the girl group, and then from there it was lots of different things that have happened, which you entered the musical theatre realm and you started to do the theatres. And it was kind of interesting that you mentioned Whitney, because one of your breakthrough musical theatre role in Australia was actually playing Rachael from the Bodyguard, which was
Rachael Marion.
which was Whitney's debut movie. That was a big moment for you, a big, like, wow moment, where you realised they had handpicked you to play this iconic role?
A 100%. Like, that is one of the highlights of my career.
Yeah.
You know, being chosen for that role, knowing that people, you know, people believed in me and thought that I could do it. Because I'll be honest right now, when I got that call, I was like, there's no way I could do this. No way in the world. I could not.
Yeah.
I am not an actress and I'm not a dancer. I can sing those songs, but all the other stuff, no. But, you know, I had to, once again, I had to have faith in myself and take that step and go, you know what, I'm here now, I'm going to have to swim.
Yes.
You know, you either sink or you swim, and I basically started swimming.
Yeah, absolutely.
And took every challenge as it came. I remember the first week when I was in rehearsal for The Bodyguard, I remember calling my management and my partner, like my boyfriend at the time, and just, you know, breaking down and saying, I don't think this is for me. Like, it's just too hard. I had no experience in acting. I had no experience in dancing. I'd never, you know, done any of those things. And, you know, and like, I guess I could say that with singing too. I never really had any professional singing lessons. I learnt in church and from my brothers and my sisters, you know, we're all quite musical. So it was scary, but it was something that I needed to do, you know, and I knew that if I were to take this step, other opportunities would come along. Yeah. And even though it was such a big step for me at the time, you know, I was freaking out, like freaking out. And like I said, there were times where I just thought, this is not for me. But again, you have to, it's so important just to have people around you who believe in you and who support you,
mm-hmm.
and who are going to be encouraging at times like that, because we all kind of go up and down, you know. And you need people to go to friends, family,
yeah,
to really kind of just encourage you to keep moving forward. And I'm so, 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 so honored, so blessed that I got that opportunity. And I thought I did what, you know, a little bit of justice to it.
Yeah.
No one's ever going to sing Whitney like Whitney, but you know, I was like, I tried my best.
you gave it your special.
I gave it my all, that's for sure.
Had nothing left in the tank afterwards.
I have nothing.
I love that song. Oh my goodness, iconic.
No, for real though.
You have gone on to do other things. You've done chess with Rob Mills, who we spoke about earlier.
Yes.
That with,
yes,
Bass, who is also amazing.
Yes. Yeah, she's amazing. She really is.
She's incredible. And I think it's really interesting. Oh, and you're going to be doing We Will Rock You.
We Will Rock You, yeah, the arena experience. Yes. For all of the kids. And, you know, I mean, whoever really, like, you know, it's pretty much the same as every other kind of production of We Will Rock You. But it's just going to have, I think, 500 students.
Oh, wow.
In the start. Yeah, it's massive. It's massive. So, yeah, I'm very excited about that. But, you know, like I said, Bodyguard for me was another stepping stone for me. And I was kind of like, this is just going to open other doors. And you're right. You know, I've had the opportunity to play roles with Matt, Rob, all these other amazing talents, you know, that I've shared the stage with. And it's all just, it's a blessing for me, really. You know, fantastic. I'm thankful for it.
What I wanted to talk to you about was The Masked Singer. Now, on a day bleeds into nightfall, and you're not here to get me through it all. I let my guard down. And then you pull the rug. I was getting kind of used to being someone you love. Oh my God. Now, this show.
Oh my God, yes, Spider.
So fun. And I think, like, there's always names that are thrown out there. And you were on, was it the first season?
The first season.
So we had Lindsay, we had Jackie O, we had Danny, who I think is the most veteran talent show host judge in the country. She's on
Yeah, episode. Yeah.
Like, give us Danny Minogue, that's all we need. And then we had James.
Yeah.
But
you're right.
What I think is really interesting about that is the costume is
such yes.
a part of the show, obviously, because it's a
yeah.
singer. But did you get, what my question for that is did you get to pick your character?
Yeah, so I, so to be honest, totally honest with you, I had come into the mix a little later
yeah.
than, you know, they had already kind of, I think I was one of the last ones to sign on.
Yeah.
And I had looked at all of the costumes and I wanted another one. I remember asking the producers, can I have this one? And they were like, no, it's already taken.
What one did you want to be?
And I wanted to be the lion.
Oh, the one that Kate Sobrano had.
Yes, Kate Sobrano had that one. And so I was like, I want to be the lion. I need the lion. And then, you know, they obviously said, no, you can't. So I was like, okay, fine. And they pretty much, I think it was, I had two to choose from, and it was Spider and I think the Monster.
Okay.
They were the last two that were left, and I pretty much was like, oh, okay, fine, Spider. And it's so funny because I actually don't like purple.
Oh, really?
I've never been a fan of the color purple.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was like, okay, well, this is kind of not working out for me. I probably won't win it. But yeah, give me Spider.
Yeah, awesome. And so did you choose your songs, or were they already pre-selected? And did you make up your blues and stuff?
No, they weren't pre-selected. We did get like a list of, you know, songs that they kind of had already cleared.
Yes.
You know, and got permission to use. So yeah, I basically just looked at that list every kind of week and I was like, okay, I'll do this one.
Yeah.
And they were, you know, they weren't, when we perform, it wasn't the whole song. So it wasn't 3 minutes and whatever, 20, 30 seconds. It was like not even a minute, really.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the songs didn't go for that long. So yeah, it was, they were definitely songs that I wanted to do,
yes,
that I wanted to perform. Yeah.
And was there a particular song that was your favourite performance or something that stands out from the show?
I never thought, like, I remember seeing the first song, the first episode and singing Toxic. Yeah. And that's one song that I never, ever, ever thought that I would kind of do justice to.
Mm.
You know, I was always like, oh, this song's not going to be, it's not kind of for me. Mm. It's very different. But I'm happy that I did it. Like, I actually love performing it.
Yeah.
I loved every minute on that stage. And it kind of went with the whole mysterious kind of Spider.
Yes.
Like, you know, theme. So, yeah, I was happy about that.
I think, like, one of the questions that one of the young kids submitted.
Yeah.
Alira.
Hi kids.
Did you know any of the other contestants on the show before they were revealed?
No, we had no idea. So I had, yeah, no idea. We would, our rehearsals, we had to pretty much wear hoodies everywhere, like these long kind of like, they almost look like, you know, the Star Wars.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Those hoodies that kind of covered you. Like it came right down to, you know, to your knees.
Yeah.
So, yeah, while we were doing rehearsals, even the performances, we were never allowed to be in the studio at the same time. We always had like a security guard with each of the artists.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we just weren't allowed to, talk to anyone. We had like a dresser who was the only one really that we could communicate with. So it was pretty full on. Like I was like, wow, this is awesome. Like, yay. I don't have to talk to anyone when I go to work. jokes. But you know, it was really like I've never done anything like that before, so it was kind of, you know, exciting. But I remember in rehearsals I would be side of stage waiting to get on after, you know, like while someone else was on stage doing their sound check, and I was like, that's that person. I could just tell, you know. I was like, I bet you anybody that's like Rob Mills, or I was like, let's get to Rada. You know, I just knew. But we just couldn't talk about it. You know, we had to, all of our little speculations and who we thought was under what mask, we couldn't chat about that.
Ooh.
So yeah, a lot of confidence.
Would you recommend others to do it?
Yeah, absolutely. It's fun. You know, it's like, it wasn't even work. It was pretty much a fun show that, you know, you got to perform your, like, songs that you liked and enjoyed performing. And, yeah, it's there's no pressure in it at all. I mean, for me, there was no pressure at all. Like, I remember having fun. I remember, and I also remember at the time when I was filming that, I was in rehearsals for Hair. Yeah. And I thank God for the Masked Singer because it actually, like, gave me a bit of a break from what I was, you know, what I was learning at the time. And that it was, I mean, Hair's a very kind of complicating
musical.
musical, yeah. So it gave me a bit of breathing space. Yeah.
So we did that, and then there was talk in the papers, in the tabloids.
Oh, yeah.
That Paulini was heading into the jungle, and you wouldn't know.
I thought you were going to say something else.
We were heading into, there was talk at the end of the year that people were guessing who was going into the jungle. One of the names being thrown around was Lindsay Lohan and Jack
Finn. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And even Paulini. And it turned out true.
You got two right. You got two right.
Got two right, yeah. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Too many dangerous toils and snares we have already come. Now, I think watching I'm a Celebrity, and it's a lot. We actually have young Josh from Mount Druitt who wanted to ask a few questions about it. One of them was what was your most favourite moment from I'm a Celebrity? Which what I'll get you to think about. I'll get you to think about that. I'll come back to that in a second. But being asked to go on a show like that, had you watched the previous seasons and had you spoken to people like Nat or even Anthony or people that had been on the show to ask their opinion about should I do it, or was it something that you felt it was time to reinvent yourself and to let people get to know an honest
who I was,
who you were? Yeah,
yeah. I had watched a few episodes here and there. I never really ever watched a whole season. Like but you know, then again, like I don't really watch a lot of TV.
Yeah.
So yeah, I didn't. I wish I did. But I do remember texting Anthony, Instagramming him and asking him, hey, like, you know, what's it like? What's it like in there? And he said it was fun. That was one of the reasons why I did it was because you're absolutely right. I wanted people to really know who I was, you know, and really get to know me. Because there'd been so many things before that, you know, I had done shows, controversial kind of stuff came out, all of that type of stuff, and I wanted to correct it. So I thought that would be a great opportunity just to get out there again. You know, I hadn't been on a show for quite a long time, like a TV show, so I thought, okay, this is great. This is a good opportunity for me. I'm going to try and, address some of the issues that people have always been wondering, you know, kind of what happened or why I never spoke about it. It definitely was something that I wanted to explore and kind of reveal who I really was.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You know, and my personality. Because I'm very laid back, you know, I'm very like almost sometimes quite tomboyish, you know, and I think people, you know, they'd always see me in dresses and looking glamorous, and that's not me. Like, you know, I'm very different from that. I'm very down to earth. I'm just like Paulini from the block, you know.
I'm Paulini.
Paulini from Bankstown.
I love that.
So yeah, I was thinking about all those things. You know, I thought that it would just be a great opportunity to set the record straight. you know, and let people into my world.
That's it. So did you, when look, yeah. it had quite the cast of characters.
Oh my lord, there was a massive personalities.
Massive personalities. Yes. Was anyone in particular that you were like, when they came in to the jungle, you were like, oh no, but completely changed your perception of them? Was there anyone that kind of shocked you?
No, I didn't know a few people who came in, so I was a bit like, I had to ask, you know, I don't know whether they showed this on the show, but I was always like, who is that? Oh, okay. And I had to, you know, I had to kind of ask some of the other celebs in the jungle who they were.
Yeah.
But one of the, so I think, you know, someone who really, like, I didn't know who she was when she arrived into the jungle, Abby.
Yes.
Abby Chatfield. I didn't know who she was. And so she was very loud and, you know, just out there. She's such a free spirit. Mm. And that kind of, you know, I was like, oh, okay, who is this chick? Mm. And I, you know, just being in the jungle with her for like a good two and a half weeks.
Yes.
Was really great because I got to know her as a person, and you know, she's like all of us, you know, we go through different things, but she's very vocal about it, which is great. Yes. Which is something that I think I wish I was more like that. I wish I was more vocal about how I felt about things, and you know, I love how she stands up for what she, you know, she says what she thinks, and you know, they're her opinions, and it's you know, it's valid. Yeah. And it should never be something that you feel like you shouldn't talk, like shouldn't be, you know, it's, that's her personality. And so I really, while I was in the jungle, I really kind of loved seeing that. And yeah, she was I think out of all of them, she was the most surprising character in there. Yeah. You know, I like I said, I didn't know much about her, but then when I did get to know her, it was awesome. It was really, yeah, it was great.
Did you like the challenges?
My highlight was I did a drinking challenge. Yeah. I don't know whether you remember, but I had the worst drink ever on I'm a Celeb. While I was doing it, I thought I was going to die. But after it, I was like, mate, that is a highlight for me. I never thought in my wildest dreams that I'd be able to do that.
Yes.
And it took a lot of strength.
Mm.
And, you know, I just pretty much said, stuff it. Give me that drink and I'm going. I'm definitely going to be the only one that can do this. So I walked away feeling like, yes, I achieved something really, yeah, like big. Yeah, so yeah, that was a highlight. I mean, it tasted like absolute shit, but that's what you got to do. You got to do those things.
It was
you got to go through the stuff. You got to go through this shit to get to the gold.
That's it. Have you friendships with the other castmates and
yeah, look, I still keep in contact, like with Jack, Jess, Abby, you know, we'll always kind of like say hi on Instagram and what are you doing, what are you up to, let's have coffee, all of that type of stuff. And I'm more like, I see all the others like on Instagram, and you know, we'll leave comments on each other's pages or send a DM, but They were such a beautiful group of people.
Yeah.
Like I am so I'm so honored to have met them, because what I loved about it was that they were from, you know, we were all from different parts of the entertainment industry. Mm. You know, there was like a cook in there. There were actresses and actors and singers and reality TV show people. Mm. You know, social media people, like it was amazing. You know, it was great to kind of, I remember our conversations that we'd have while we were in the jungle. We'd just talk about, you know, oh, what is it like being an influencer, or what's it like being a reality TV star, or, you know, teach us how to cook, like Colin, you know, like it's so good to get that, I guess, the just their experience in their field. Yeah. That's what was beautiful. I thought it was great.
Oh, that's so good to hear. What's next? So I think one of the questions that Josh also wanted to know was, you have released a lot of songs and you are a songwriter as well. Is there was there a particular song that you wrote that you feel is the most special to you and it's something that you felt really compelled to write and get out there?
I remember writing a song called Scarlet. Which means, you know, was a turning point for me, because I'd never really kind of written songs about my experiences. Mm-hmm. You know, I was always like, oh, let's talk about love and let's talk about like us going on a date or whatever it is, but never something as deep as that. And I'm glad it's a massive achievement for me, because it's something that I went through, and I was able to, you know, release that song. And the amount of women that I've had texts from, mm-hmm. and messages from, just saying how much that kind of resonated with them, and that's kind of got them through their hard times.
Mm.
That's what it's all about for me.
Yeah.
Like if it's one person, I love that. It makes me feel like what I'm doing really is, it's purposeful for me,
mm.
you know, like gives me purpose when people say things like that to me.
Yeah.
That's definitely a song that I'm very proud of.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'll never forget that. Like, it's like when I say it was a turning point, it really was, you know, healing for me.
Yeah.
And I knew that I wasn't this, it was never about me. It was always about other people listening to this song, them relating to it and getting through their own battles,
mm-hmm.
you know, and knowing that we all, at the end of the day, we all go through the, you know, we all go through difficulties. It's not just, you're not going through it alone. There's so many other, you know, you always have the support there of others.
Absolutely.
Sorry, my nose is,
that's okay.
My nose is running.
So you did release, so you are an independent artist now, aren't you? You're independent.
I am, yes.
So, yeah. So your last full-length album that you released, that's an independent album.
Yes.
Did you have a lot of freedom in the writing with that? Did you write a lot of the material on that album?
Yeah, so I pretty much wrote like the whole thing.
Yeah.
The only song I didn't write was Fly.
Mm.
I think that was it. Everything else I kind of co-wrote with different people.
Mm-hmm.
That was, again, another, you know, exciting part to my journey, was to be able to have that freedom of just sitting in a studio and writing stuff and, you know, vocally coming up with melodic lines that I love. You know, and that I thought, okay, this kind of fits. Yeah. I was like, to be, you know, really, I was kind of producing the whole, like, I produced the album, you know. So that's another thing that I feel like what an opportunity to get, because I know a lot of artists wouldn't get that, you know, and I know that there's always some kind of someone from the record label overseeing things. But I really am grateful for that. And I had a small an independent label that helped me, you know, helped me also. But they really did give me the freedom to just kind of create. And that's kind of what I did.
Amazing. So do you, so what's something you'd give young people that want to start writing and recording their own music? What's some tips that you'd give them to do that?
Okay, so first of all, I think when you start, because this, I'm talking from my experience, right? I used to think that I wasn't a great writer. So when I say that, I was like, oh, is what I'm saying making sense? Oh, is that the right word? Is that how you actually spell it? Is that how you say it? You know, is it in the right, are you using the word in the right sentence kind of thing? And I think that's one of the biggest things that you have to get over. Don't worry about that. You write what you need to write, and then things, as you practice that, as you get more experience in writing and recording, all of those things will fall into place, you know. But don't be scared of taking that first step to write, you know, because like I said, I used to think that all the time, like, am I using these words right? You know, am I spelling this right? All of that stuff, all the doubt, all the clutter that comes with, you know, not being sure about yourself. All of that stuff you need to get over that. You need to get over it. You need to just keep writing, keep doing it. You know, practice makes perfect. That's one thing that my dad used to always say, practice makes perfect. So keep at it until you feel like, okay, well, I've improved from what I was like last month.
Yes.
And be real, like write about your experiences, because that's what people connect with.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, I don't have anything against like people talking about being in a club and all that type of stuff. That's cool, you know, that's feel good music, and sometimes you just need to hear songs that really kind of don't make you think too much. But I know in the last few years that I've been doing this, like when I hear a song that I resonate with, it's because that person is just pouring their heart out in that song, and I'm like, I am right there with you. Like, I feel every lyric, I feel every note. You know, the melodic line even speaks to me.
Yes.
And that's what you want. You know, you want that. You want people to kind of listen to songs and go, I totally get what you're saying, and I believe it, and that's going to give me strength to do what I got to do in life.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
So yeah, that's what I'd say.
I love that.
Stay, be real, you know, be real to yourself and stay real. Stay real.
That's it. Look, I do want to say a really big thank you to you for taking the time
out
to chat to us today, and for sharing your worlds of wisdom, your words of wisdom.
My world, yes. Your I world. Can go with that too. That makes sense.
That's my melodic line.
Yeah. But you know what? Thank you so much for having me. I'm really honored to sit down and like chat about, you know, my experiences. And I hope it really like it does resonate with other kids out there. You know, because I was that kid. I was really that kid.
Yeah.
Who, you know, who always thought that I, you know, who always kind of had that thought of, I don't have much, you know, my family aren't from a lot, but you got to keep moving forward.
That's it.
And yeah.
Look, I do want to say a really big thank you again. And we're very honoured that you're here and talking to us and sharing your story with us, because I think there's kids that will be watching this today that will find their place in your story. And I think that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
That's what inspires people. And thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you. Hey, guys. I hope you are all well in lockdown. I just thought I'd do something really, something special. I'm going to be performing for you a cappella, a song that I wrote, I think it was a year ago. It's called 2020. I hope you guys enjoy it. All right. 2020 cutting ties, procrastinating cutting ties with you out of lousy perfect guys. This 2020 vision ain't come through. 2020 cutting ties, procrastinating cutting ties with you out of lousy perfect guys. This 2020 vision ain't come through.
Did you ever think the day would come, sitting all alone on the phone? 'Cause I just won't let you hug it out with your best friend, Mr. Jones. Dancing around and acting like a clown, all the good we didn't talk about. Now I gotta push away the doubt, but first we need to talk it out.
Our patience is tested, texted.
Put your feelings in the crate down.
It's not fair. People acting like they don't care. But now I feel like we are more aware. See, divided we fall. Let's come together, stand tall.
2020 cutting ties with you. Fascinating cutting ties with you. I'm the last perfect eye.